Assalamualaikum guys, what's up? Hope you guys are doing well, hope you guys are okay. Today's video is gonna be something different. And it's gonna be a sad video. I think most of you guys follow me on Facebook. You check my Facebook, what I posted. And on Instagram, and my story. Those who follow me on my socials. You guys know if you guys are watching. And as you can tell by the title, it's a sad video today. So, basically what happened yesterday, my friend passed away. Some of you may know this. I know Ruxa, you know his. Baron, if you're watching this. Zane, you know who he is. And whoever else, I can't remember. You guys know who he is, even I know who he is. The rest, you guys don't know, so obviously I'll just tell you. Some of you may know because I messaged you about it though. But for those who don't know, I said in my video, so yeah, as you guys heard it, my friend passed away yesterday. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajiun. Like, I didn't even know, like, my friend's sister, she messaged me around 6. And I was too busy playing GTA, like, I didn't even check in on the messages. I was too busy concentrating in the game. And around 8:30 in the evening, in the afternoon, I went on a messenger, and I was thinking he was that. Then I thought, oh yeah, I know his mom and sister. And she rang me and told me my aunt passed away. And I was like, what? Seriously? No, you know, right? And she goes, yeah. And I said, how did he die? Did he just die in his sleep or did he have corona? She goes, no, he just died. Because obviously he has health problems and other problems in his life. Like he told me, and his family knows. I don't say it because it's not my personal thing. It's his and his family personal thing. So yeah, I was a little shocked, man, about when my friend died. Like, this is the first ever time I lost a friend. Like, I know everyone here has got families. You got granddad, grandmas, auntie, uncles, cousins, your mom and dad, your brothers, sisters, your nieces and nephews. You all love them so much. You don't even want to lose them all. Like, just like if you got a best friend who you truly love, who you trust, who you share your feelings to. Like, you text all day and talk on call and that stuff. Especially when it's your best friend. The saddest moment, especially important when if you lose family member, that's really important thing. Friend is as well, like, but that's the main thing is family. Friend is like second thing important. But after that, I was like shocked. I had no words to say. I was thinking, oh my god, Marwan, how did you leave everyone? You left your best friend behind, which is me. I was shocked, and you left your family behind. And I was thinking, your family is gonna miss you so much. They had to take care of that. But extra taking care of you because of your health problems. Like, you look fine. Basically, he looks fine. He could walk. Like, he sits on a wheel. I've seen him in college. Like, sometimes struggle. Like, he needed, like, water, like, something on his bag. And then sometimes me or my other friends or his teachers, I see them give it to him because he can't. He doesn't want to walk around in college because he finds it too difficult. Home is a different thing. Home is just in your room playing video games, just not walking down much. College, like, you have to walk around, sit down, like, you know, I mean, go to the toilet, go to have lunch, or go out of town, etc. But yeah, for him, it's just different. So yeah, just. So may Allah bless him. And he's probably got buried now. But I'll ask it. I mentioned his sister. After Zohar Asr, they're going to bury his body. Hopefully, they buried him in the mosque. I wanted to go. It's in Mosul, it's in Abu Bakr, I forgot the last bit called Masjid in Mosul. It's not that far, I wanted to go, but I couldn't go. So his sister video called me, then I saw his face, I saw his picture, I was like, oh my god, man, he left your own best friend. And I used to think, like, oh, I used to treat him as my little brother. We used to have a laugh and joke in college. Like, he used to talk to me about gaming, like, what food do you like? And he used to send pictures of foods and your gaming and that stuff. Like, you know what I mean? Now that's not gonna happen. So yeah, that's one of the saddest thing. Let me guys comment down below who's watching. So I know. I really appreciate it. And thanks for everyone for commenting on my Facebook, liking it, messaging me private on Instagram, Facebook, and sometimes I'll be getting messages all day. Like, my niece and nephew, they messaged me. Then I told my friend yesterday that he died. And they commented on my posts. So yeah, so sorry for you. Like, at the end of the day, I feel kind of bad because I lost a best friend. Like, if you guys are in my place, yeah, you guys would have lost your best friend or your parents or family members. Everyone would be the same. They'd be sad and upset. Obviously, I was crying a bit. I'm crying a little bit now. My tears are coming out, but I'm not trying to cry too much. Yesterday, I was crying for a little bit, and today in the morning on video call, I saw his dead body inside the glass thing, whatever it's called, where he put his dead body in. That's when I was crying a little bit. Like, I feel so sorry for you. I feel so sorry for you. You left your best friend, you left your family members who were kind of look after you, who brought you up in this world, and that sort of, like I said, you have to appreciate your parents to work for, like, especially when you're born into this world, they have to work so hard for you, like, etc. I don't want to say, but you know what I mean. They love you, they take care of you, they give you right advices, they won't tell you to go for the wrong path, do wrong deeds, be sinful. That's what everyone should try not to do. Being the wrong sins or being the wrong. You know what I mean? So, yeah. Inshallah, I'll be fine. Like I said, thanks for all the messages that I got all day. I was even busy most of the time. I tried to reply to everyone on Facebook and Instagram and that stuff. So, yeah, I bet Ruxo people would be crying maybe. And Baron is upset and Zane. I know you guys will miss him so much. Comment down below so I know you're watching. I know you will watch this, but just comment down below so I know that you guys care about me and Marwa and or anyone else who you love or trust. And that's so, yeah. Like I said, if you guys haven't checked my GTA video I done on PS4, go watch that out. The first time I ever done gaming on a long time console, bro. Like I used to do on PS3, but then I still have it, but it's upstairs, I don't use it. I can't even sell it because I don't have a original controller for it though. It works fine, condition's good. But yeah, but so I'm gonna keep it. So yeah. So I'm trying to learn how to edit, but I can't fully do it, so yeah, but it doesn't matter. I'm gonna record on PS4 and I know how to do it. Rather than doing any phone that you can't see it, you guys just let me guys know. I'll be doing another gaming video on my PS4 in a couple of weeks or in a few days. And I will come back to gaming on my phone shortly. But not yet, when I feel like when I'm ready, then I'll. So I'm gonna kind of gonna do both. So yeah, stay tuned for that. And yeah, I don't know what to say. So I said everything about Marwan. That stuff. I'm still upset, but I'll be fine. Inshallah, trust me. But yeah, anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you smash the thumbs up button. Make sure you like, comment, share the video. And I'll be doing another gaming video in a couple of weeks, a couple of days on my PS4, and very soon on my phone as well. So yeah, that's all I have to say about the bad news. So yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. As always, stay tuned for videos and assalamu alaikum, guys.